Hey guys, welcome to Atari 37 Day. I'm reviewing this, which is a Marvel Legends series Black Panther movie, Black Panther action figure from Wave 2. This is pretty cool. We have the Legends series, nice clear view in box, the Black Panther movie logo, some pretty cool artwork on the side. We have Build-A-Figure Wave, we can see the Black Panther symbol, so pretty cool. On the back, we have this really, really nice artwork of the Black Panther, and we have a bio on him from the start of the movie, as this is the suit that he wore in Civil War and the start of the film. Then we have the other characters available, and the Build-A-Figure all together. So yeah, let's open this up. Oh, here we have him. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe this Black Panther action figure is a re-release of the Captain America Civil War one. There might be some differences. I know the head's new, but other than that, I think it is pretty much just a re-release. I never picked up that action figure. It was kind of rare. I think it was like the, you know, there's always like one character in the wave that's a little bit hard to find. To me, it was that character. So a little bit disappointed about that, but glad that I finally got him in this wave. I do think though, if you've already picked that up, you might dislike this one because of that, but at the same time, it's pretty cool because it gives people a chance to get it again. And I absolutely love this suit too. In my opinion, this is the best version of the suit that he's worn on screen, so I'm really glad that they re-released this. I like the silver on the helmet. It looks so cool. I like how it goes around his mask and comes out the sides here. His white eyes are really cool too, and his ears, they have some texturing to the side down here. It looks pretty cool. There's some more of that texture detail, and then he's got his like silver chain that go through, and pretty neat. And one of the reasons this is my favorite is just because it's got this little detailing that goes throughout the suit. That's one of the things I've always liked about this one, and you can see it evident. And the new suit does have that a little bit, but it's just not as much or as cool in my opinion. And I like how that goes through with the little texturing, and it just makes it stand out more to me than other like battle suits or anything like that. And I honestly wish they would consider going back to this for the sequel. And it's got some silver on the arms here, which are pretty cool. I love the claws. They have been painted silver, which are very nice. Always like when they do that, so that's pretty neat. He's got some silver there on his arms too. Again, some more texturing around the legs and knees. And then his feet have these rim of silver that go around them. So pretty cool in terms of detailing. In terms of articulation, you got a 360 at the head. You can look up and down. There's a 360 at the arm, swing out the shoulder, 360 there, double jointed elbow, 360 at the wrist, and it is on hinges. You have a 360 at the torso and an ab crunch. That's pretty good. The legs do come forwards, backwards, and outwards. 360 at the thigh, double jointed knees, and the feet do pivot and move up and down. So in terms of articulation detailing, I think this figure is absolutely amazing with that. Now for the accessories. You mainly just get the Build-A-Figure piece and the unmasked head, so I'll show that off. I've yet to review the Avengers Infinity War Vibranium Black Panther from this wave, but in my opinion, this is probably the best version of an unmasked head sculpt for this character. Like, I didn't feel the wave one of the movie figures were that good for him, and I didn't think Civil War did that good of a job either, but I think this one has really done a pretty good job, and just they've gotten everything right with this. The hair is really good. I like it. I also like how they did the beard and the eyes. It just looks a lot better with this one, and I think the Avengers Infinity War one from this wave is going to be similar, just like a different expression, so I think those two are probably going to end up being the best. But yeah, I think this is a really good likeness, and I like the smirk too. I think they did a really good job with how they made this head sculpt, and definitely one of the best reasons to pick this up, because it's a lot better than the other two that we had, and it's just really, it represents the character and is awesome. So yeah. Alright, and lastly, here is a comparison with the 2018 movie Black Panther with the Civil War suit. And as you can see, they're vastly different. I do prefer this one just because I like this suit. This one does have a bit more articulation and probably a bit more detailing, but I just really like this suit better. And you can kind of see what I mean with like how this one has the lines and the texture. This one does have texture, it's just not to the extent of that, and that's why I don't like it. But that's personally like a preference in terms of suits. Overall, this is still a really nice action figure, and so is this one. It's just a preference. I also don't like how this isn't as long as this one is. But yeah, so for the most part, I think this is pretty cool, and I definitely recommend picking this up. If you already have it, though, you might not want to go back for it, just because it is, in my opinion, I think it's the same one, just with a new head. But yeah, for the most part, it is pretty cool, and really glad they re-released this. Thank you for watching. Please rate, like, and subscribe.